Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about the differences between POJO and JavaBean. Both POJO and JavaBean are the classes used to define Java objects for more readability. Let us understand with an example. Let me create a POJO class. By the way, POJO is plain old Java object. I'm going to name my class as student. And this student can have name attribute, can have marks, can have roll number as well, right? So int roll number. And we wanted to initialize the values to this. For that, I'm going to have a constructor. Using the constructor, we are going to pass the values to these attributes. In roll number and marks, we will initialize the passed parameters to these attributes. Roll number equal to passed roll number, and this marks is equal to the parameter marks which is passed to the constructor, right? Now how to read the attributes? So for that we'll generate the getters. So let's generate getters for these three attributes. Now let me create a new class where I'll name my class as POJO main, where we are going to have the main method here. And I'm going to create a new object, student object, and we need to pass parameter values to this, right? The first one being name. I'll pass it as Mahesh, and second attribute is roll number, right? Yeah, roll number, let's say for example 101, mark say for example 75. Okay, and intentionally I'm going to modify the name. So if you observe, name is declared as default, right? So I am able to modify the name here, right? And then now let's actually call the getters. Get name. Get marks. Sorry. S dot get roll number, and then we'll have the marks. H dot get marks. Now let us execute this program. And we can see the output here. So we passed Mahesh and we modified the name to Mahesh Babu, right? So we can see the name, roll number, and marks get printed here. So this is what we call it as a POJO class. POJO is plain old Java object, and we can see the structure here. So it need not be in a conventional format, so it can be we can have any attributes, meaning like it can be of any data type, it can have any access modifier, we can either have the constructor or not, this is not mandatory, and we can have getters, setters, or only getters as well. This is the structure of the POJO. Now let us understand what JavaBean is. So let me create a new class for JavaBean. So I'll name my class as employee, and the first thing here is in JavaBean, we need to implement the serializable interface. This is because mainly JavaBeans are used for the enterprise Java application where users access the data from the server via a network, right? So the data has to be streamed into serial format into and out of the user's machine. That's the reason we definitely need to implement the serializable interface for a JavaBean class. And the second thing is, whatever the data member inside JavaBean, they have to be private. So all the attributes of the JavaBean class has to be private. So employee can have employee ID, which has to be private, as we are going to define this class as a JavaBean class, right? Int or string, we can have employee name. Maybe we can have salary. And another thing is a JavaBean class has to have a no argument constructor. So let's have a no argument constructor. And a JavaBean class should always have both getters and setters. So let's generate both getters and setters for all the attributes. This is our JavaBean class. So what we have serializable interface that has to be implemented by the JavaBean class. All the data attributes should be private. A JavaBean class has to have a no argument constructor, and it has to have a getters and setters for the attributes, and all these has to be public to access the private attributes. Now let us create a new class, which we'll call it as bean main, where we are going to create the main method, create an object for the employee class, and we are going to set the attributes here. Employee ID, which can be something like this, e dot set name, e dot set salary, some 10,000 like that. And how do we actually read these values? Using the getters, e dot get name, get employee ID, get salary. And we can see here is output, right? So the name, employee ID, and salary. And now let's actually see the differences between Pojo class and JavaBean. So if you observe, the first difference is like JavaBean class has to implement the serializable interface, and Pojo need not actually extend any class, or it's not mandatory to definitely implement any interface. And here if you observe, Pojo class can have any access modifier for its attributes, but all the attributes in JavaBean class has to be private. And Pojo class can have a constructor. It can be no arg constructor, it can be parameterized constructor, or it need not have the constructor, but JavaBean class has to have the no argument constructor. It's mandatory, right? And you can either have getters and setters or only getters in the Pojo class, but in JavaBean we should definitely have the getters and setters, and that too with the access modifier as public. So these are the main differences between Pojo and JavaBean class. So simply we can say all JavaBean classes are Pojos, but all Pojos need not be the JavaBean. So these are the main differences. And in this video, we discussed about Pojo, what's Pojo class, what JavaBean class, and what are the main differences between Pojo class and JavaBean class. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.